हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स ट्यूस फॉर यू। इन दिस वीडियो वी शैल लर्न व्हाट इज मेंट बाय इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री फंक्शन। वी आल्सो लर्न व्हाट इज मेंट बाय प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू ब्रांच एंड वी शैल सी सम एग्जांपल हाउ टू फाइंड प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू ऑफ ए इनवर्स ट्रिग्नोमेट्री फंक्शन। दिस इज पार्ट वन and the inverse trigonometry function is the third part of the chapter trigonometric function for the 12th standard. It is also important for JEE main and advanced exam. This chapter also helps for the preparation of CET exam. So we shall start with inverse trigonometry function. First we should know what is meant by inverse function. Suppose a function f from set A to set B. Set A is called domain and set B is called codomain. Is 1 1 and on 2. Then its inverse exists. Then its inverse exists. It is given by F inverse from A from B to A. It is also 1 1 and on 2. What is meant by 1 1? 1 1 means for distinct values of x belongs to A. Suppose x1 not equal to x2 is belongs to A, then f of x1 is not equal to f of x2, then the function is 1 1. On 2 means every value of B, there is a pre-image in A, is called on 2 function. Therefore, if a function from set A to B is 1 1 and on 2, then its inverse exists and it is given by F inverse of B to A, which is also 1 1 on 2. Therefore, in inverse function, the domain of the function A is codomain of the function F inverse and the codomain of the function f is the domain of the function f inverse. Now we shall see whether the sign or all trigonometric function is 1 1 or on 2. Now sine function is defined on set of real number and its range is close interval 1 minus 1 1. Now the domain of the sine function is set of real number and the range is minus 1 to 1. The close interval means it takes all n points minus 1 and 1. Now if you observe the graph of sine function, this is the graph of the sine function. Here domain is the values of the x, that is r, and the range is the values of the y, that is y is equal to sin x, that is minus 1 to 1. So this is a wave like a curve. If you observe for some values of the x, for example when x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 0. When x is equal to pi, y is also 0. When x is equal to 2 pi, it is also 0. Similarly, if we take x is equal to minus pi, it is also 0. If we take x is equal to minus 2 pi, it is also 0. Therefore, for many values of the x, we get the same values of the y. So, sine function is not 1, 1. On to the domain, codomain or range minus 1 to 1. In order to make the sine function 1 1 and on 2, we restrict the domain R so that it will be become 1 1 on 2. We divide the set of real number, that is domain of the sine function, into sub interval. If we take minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, that is the subset minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. We take first interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Then pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Or 3 pi by 2 to 5 pi by 2. So on. Similarly to the left side of the y-axis. Minus 3 pi by 2 to minus pi by 2. Minus 5 pi by 2 to minus 3 pi by 2. So on. Now, if we define the function in the subset, in every subset, then the function is 1 1 on 2. For example, if we take pi by 2 minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, that is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Now if you observe this, sine of minus pi by 2 is minus 1, sine of 0 is 0, and sine of pi by 2 is 1. So it is 1 1 on 2. Therefore sine function is defined on minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 to close interval minus 1 to 1. It is now 1 1 on 2. Similarly, if we take other subset, it is sine function is 1 1 on 2. But if we take this interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, then this interval is called principal value branch. Is principal value branch of sine function. Now the sine function minus close interval minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 to close interval minus 1 to 1 is 1 1 on 2. Therefore by definition of inverse, we get the inverse function. It is denoted by sine inverse close interval minus 1 to 1 to close interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. In this way we define the inverse of a trigonometry function, sine function. Similarly, now if you take the cosine function, the graph of the cosine function is also like a sine function. Here domain is set of all real number and range is my close interval minus 1 to 1. Now if you take x is equal to 0, we get sine of x, that is y is equal to 1. When we take x is equal to pi by 2, we get also 1. When we take x is equal to minus pi by 2, we also get 1. So when we define cosine function, cos function from set R to close interval minus 1 to 1, then it is not 1 1 and onto. Then we can restrict the domain of the cosine function so that it is become 1-1 onto. Now we divide the set of real number into sub interval 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi, to the left of the y axis minus pi to 0, minus 2 pi to minus pi, that is minus 2 pi minus pi minus pi 0 0 pi pi 2 pi, so on. In each interval cosine function is now 1-1 onto. Now you observe that in the interval 0 to pi cosine of 0, cos of 0 is 1, cos of pi by 2 is 0, cos of pi is equal to minus 1. So cosine function cos of 0 to pi to close interval minus 1 is 1-1 onto. So we define its sine, its inverse function. Inverse function is given by cos inverse close interval minus 1 to 1 to close interval 0 to pi. So this is also 1-1 onto. It is called inverse of the cosine function. Similarly, we can define, we can restrict all the domain of the trigonometry function, and in the respective domain we get all the trigonometry function are 1-1 onto. Now we shall see the domain and range of the inverse trigonometry function. Now the domain and range of the inverse trigonometry function with their respective principal value branch are as follows. First, sine inverse close interval minus 1 to 1 to close interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 is the principal value branch of the sine inverse x. Similarly, cos inverse x, the close interval minus 1 to 1 to close interval 0 pi. The close interval 0 pi is principal branch of the cosine inverse, cos inverse x. Sine inverse R2 open interval minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Open interval means all the endpoints does not belong to this interval. It is minus pi by 2, pi by 2 does not belong to this interval. So the principal value branch is open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Sec inverse R, except open interval minus 1, 1 to close interval 0 to pi, except pi by 2. The principal value branch of sec inverse is close interval 0 to pi except pi by 2. Cosec inverse R minus open interval minus 1 to 1 minus close interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 except 0. Cot inverse R open interval 0 to pi. These are the domain and range of the inverse function and their respective principal value branches. We shall see how to find the principal value. Example, find the principal values of the following. number 1 sin inverse of minus 1 of, number 2 cos inverse of minus 1 by 2, number 3 cot inverse of minus 1 upon root 3. The first example is sin inverse of minus 1 half. Let we denote this is x. X is equal to sin inverse of minus 1 half. Therefore, by definition, sin x is equal to minus 1 half. We know that sin of pi by 6 is equal to 1 half. Therefore, we multiply minus, minus sin pi by 6 is equal to minus 1 half. Therefore, we know that sin of minus theta is minus sin theta, and therefore it is sin of minus pi by 6 is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now, this we shall check whether this angle minus pi by 2 belongs to the principal branch of the sin inverse functions. Principal branch of the sin inverse x is close interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, minus pi by 6 is greater than minus pi by 2 and less than pi by 2. And therefore, the principal value, the principal value of sin inverse of minus 1 half is minus pi by 6. The second example, cos inverse of minus 1 half. Let x is equal to cos inverse of minus 1 half. Therefore, cos x is equal to minus 1 half. We know that cos of pi by 3, that is cos 60, is equal to 1 half. Therefore, minus cos pi by 3 is equal to minus 1 half. By using allied angle formula, cos of pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. Pi minus theta belongs to the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, cos is negative, so it is minus theta. Using that, minus cos of pi by 3 is equal to cos of pi minus pi by 3. So this is equal to cos of 2 pi by 3. Therefore, cos of 2 pi by 3 is equal to minus 1 half. The principal value branch of cos inverse function is 0 pi, close interval 0 pi. Therefore, 2 pi by 3 is greater than 0 and less than pi. Therefore, the principal value of cos inverse minus 1 half is 2 pi by 3. But third, cot inverse of minus 1 upon root 3. Let x is equal to cot inverse of minus 1 upon root 3. Therefore, by definition, cot x is equal to minus 1 upon root 3. We know that cot of pi by 3 is equal to 1 upon root 3. Multiplying by minus, minus cot of pi by 3 is equal to minus 1 upon root 3. The principal value branch, the principal value branch of cot inverse function is 0, open interval 0, pi. Therefore, by using allied angle formulae, cot of pi minus theta is equal to minus cot theta. Therefore, minus cot pi by 3 is equal to cot of pi minus pi by 3. So this is equal to cot of 2 pi by 3. Therefore, cot of 2 pi by 3 is equal to minus 1 upon root 3. And 2 pi by 3 is greater than 0 and less than pi. Therefore, the principal value of cot inverse of minus 1 upon root 3 is 2 pi by 3.